Hello and welcome to Schiphol. On the map you'll see we're heading away down to Cape Town, South Africa. It's a cruising day at 33,000 feet. Flight time is about nearly 11 hours, but of course we'll be accelerating time once we have departed. So, let's get everything up and running. Parking brakes. Set battery switch on. There we are. APU start. Speed break the race track, and I've got a fair NDIS control, it's auto. On. Specs. On. Let's get the FMC sorted out, make sure that's all in order. There we go. So, position in it, we are in EHAM. There we go. Set that. Departure should all be set. Yep. Arrival. Index. F page performance. So reserves 10. Cruising altitude. We're cruising to 330 feet. Cost index 40. There we go. That's the limit set. Yeah, take off flaps. 5 degrees. Yeah, that's all good. Okay, so I think we're set for that. Everything we want to there. Get them up. Jesus. Well, I've got the charts open already. Airport 024. Let's see my arrival charts. And, let's see. Airport. Rounding runway 19. Yeah. Awesome. Okay. So, hydraulics are on, start clearance requested, parking brake set, take that off, left and push back, start sectors. Yeah. 33,000 feet. Let's set flight directors on. There we go. As we prepare to leave. That should do. Push back. Brakes on. So we got the engine started, AP generator on, so starting up, starting on, AP generator off. So flight computers are on, APUs are on. Turn that off. Have lights, runways, taxi lights will come on now. That awesome. I think we've got everything set that we need to set. Set the weather radar tracking on that. Wings are clear. Five degrees on the flaps. We want coming around to line up on the runway for our flight down to Cape Town 2019. I think one of my first videos for KLM on this channel was to Cape Town. So finally, after all that time, revisiting it. It'll be nice. A shame we always fly into Cape Town in the dark. I really want to do a daytime flight into Cape Town. But We just go with what's what. Okay, those are all set. Set logo, set. Passenger signs are on. Everything else that needs to be on, I believe, is. We need on, at least on this rather simplified version of the Dreamliner. Change the barrier to the QNH rather than inches, never mind. Quite a nice day in Amsterdam. And rotate. Positive rate, gear up. Autopilot on. VNAV engaged. Right. Wrong way of the flaps. Barometrics. There we go. So flaps are up, gear is up. Water brake, I should have set reject to take off. I didn't forget to do that, never mind. We're climbing out now, we got VNAV on, LNAV on, flaps have attracted. Turn those lights off, off, off. Oops. Seatbelt signs can be turned off. We will go to our other view now. As we say goodbye to Amsterdam and the Netherlands, we will see you on the other side for our approach into Cape Town. Sit back, relax, enjoy your flight. suppose I should say welcome back. We've got a bit of a headwind here. Not by too much though. 3 knots. Let's see what weather we can expect in Cape Town. Overcast, 20 degrees. Funnily enough, in real life, the Amsterdam to KLM flight is, in fact, arrived. It's quite funny. Okay, we are approaching the top of the ascent as we arrive onto runway 19 in Cape Town. Let's see the last remnants of that down a bit, shall we? Last remnants of daylight ahead. We're in South Africa now, heading down at the west coast into Cape Town. Now we'll shortly be initiating our descent. Pretty clear evening, although I think the weather was forecast to be overcast in Cape Town, so we'll have to see what we get upon arrival into the South African city. So we need to descend down to 3,000 feet. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Begin our descent. So yeah, we're coming in on, let's look up what arrival, we're coming in on the Eta 1B arrival. Look at that, Eta 1B arrival. Brings us in from Erdes. And a little leap round for the final approach into Cape Town. We will need to keep ourselves about 6,000 feet as we reach or by Erdes. To be at 10,000, so let's reset that up a minute, because I don't want to hit high mountains on our way in. We'll set ourselves to 7,000 feet, there we go, and then we do like a little loop round. We could probably work it out ourselves, but anyway, that is how we're approaching into Cape Town today. Depending on the weather, I don't think we'll get a glance at Table Mountain, unfortunately. How many times I've flown to Cape Town Flight Simulator and never seen Table Mountain, because I always arrive in the dark. It's a KLM flight, it's always scheduled to arrive at night time, which is a bit frustrating. Okay, so we can check a few things. on our init ref page, right, the approach page, so we will be landing. Imagine that. There, thereabouts. Legs, there we go. So the other page is the link descent forecast. Is that even operation? I don't think it is. That's a shame. No, that's not even functional, unfortunately. That's a shame. It'd be nice to have a fully functional Dreamliner on Microsoft Flight Simulator or any heavy aircraft, actually. Hopefully PMDG will get their 777 on here before too long, so I used to love flying that back on P3D. Although I really, really want to get onto the 747 at some point. Never flying that. So it'd be good to finally do so. So as we continue our descent down to Cape Town. Really wish we were landing in daytime, but never mind. We will make do with what it is. Is that 80 or 60 miles out? 80 miles out, so good. We're pretty much on profile. This rate of descent, we may ease it back a little bit, actually. Make sure we don't get too low too soon. need to set our local QNH. Should do that as we get down lower. We've got our speed set for arrival. That wind is bothering me. It's almost like live weather's not working at the moment. What is on? Meta. Facts. No meta available. Interesting. Because we should be getting overcast conditions, but we're not. So something tells me with that. That 3-knot wind. We're not seeing true representation of weather for some reason. I don't know if it's down or not. Let's have a look. Just seems odd that we're getting that weather. There is Cape Town. See, it's not covered in cloud, which makes me suspect that the weather is not working correctly, which is a shame. Yeah, it's a bit annoying about the clear skies. I wonder when that kicked in. I should watch back on the video. Anyway, let's focus on the matter at hand, which is landing the plane. We are a little low. Let's see. Let's bring that right back. Otherwise, we're going to be way too low too soon. We're just coming into LS, actually. Information. So we're going to keep above 6,002 at the moment, then we'll drop down our approach. Incidentally, as we come down to 10,000 feet, we can reduce that to 250 speed. And we'll put strobe lights on, idiot. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll shortly be arriving into Cape Town in preparation for landing. Please ensure your seats in upright position. The tray tables are stowed. Decrease the rate of descent, and we need to angle in for an angle of attack at 3,000 feet. Terrain map on. Probably a bit more used to us than anything else. That's 700 feet, and we want the 3,000 feet. So 40, 30 to 9,000 feet. Now we could have the rate of descent we're going, I think. Oh, that's 109.1 is correct. So, shame about the live weather. At least to get a nice view of Cape Town. I wonder at what point that happened. I might. Let's keep an eye on the, there's our ILS. That's just across to the side. Yeah, 20 miles out. Let's just dip it down a little bit more. With 3,000 feet to descend. Need a local QNH as well. Is that back up again? They'll return in shortly. Is that right back? Bit of terrain on. I think we're good for terrain. Let's just have a little look out. Difficult to see anything really. See some hills there. Should avoid those quite nicely. Coming around the top of them anyway. Start slowing shortly as we arrive into. I'm just really annoyed there's no live weather. It's very frustrating. As you can see, we're well underneath the glide slope. Let's turn in. Expecting a runway 19. Slow the plane down. On. So you never know, you might just see Table Mountain. But I think you can see it head here. You probably won't on your YouTube, but I can just see it silhouetted against the night sky. Okay, let's configure the aircraft for landing. Auto brake needs to be on. Spoilers are armed. Localizer set. Not sure where it's taking me, that's interesting. So I'm going to do anything stupid. That would appear to be our runway down there. We'll start deploying the flaps. Slow the aircraft down some more. It's at 160 landing speed. Really not sure where we're going now. Ah, Jesus, what's this plane doing? I forgot it does this. Crap. Say that autopilot off for it buggers everything up. That's Table Mountain anyway. Gear down, shall we? That's it. Cable tape. Okay, cable. Table mountain silhouetted against the backdrop there. Got a good rate of descent going on here. Just keep that angled appropriately. Start turning now. Don't come away too much. Ease that turn out. Should nail this with any luck. I don't know why this, if you go off piste while the autopilot throws a wobbly like that when you try and get onto the glide slope. It's a mystery to me. Seem a little bit high on the peppies. Let's try and get that nose to come down a bit. Trim it up. Speed. 1,000 feet checked. Okay, crack, you come too far the other way now. Nice down. Nearly fell out the sky there. I think we took just a bit too much power off at the end, didn't we? But we're down. That was an interesting landing, that's for sure. Let's get the airport map up. Okay, don't really want to go down this tiny taxiway at the end, but I don't think we've got much choice. So yeah, we're down in Cape Town, folks. Oh, I see. Forgot it works like that. F2, and then you have to put the throttle power on, never mind. So yeah, you can actually see Table Mountain in the haze in the distance there. Man, it's pretty cool. God, there's still... I mean, the turning circle on the thing is better than it was. It's still not grey, as you can see. Nonetheless, we are here in Cape Town, folks. Make our way to the now we'll have a look at that landing, because as I say, we took the we took a pair off and it just dropped like a stone. Fortunately, we just managed to avoid disaster. Smash it to the runway. It was interesting that it suddenly just dropped. Maybe it's had too much on the down. Trim. Anyway, this looks like a bespoke airport. Nice. Here we are. Cape Town. Where are we going to park this thing then? Park it up against the terminal, makes sense, I guess. Come along a few gates. So here we are with all the aircraft you'd expect. Oh, look at that, there's a KLM plane here. How about that? That's actually quite realistic, because there is one here in real life at the moment. That's quite impressive. If we can just turn in, park at our gates. Bit more power. Come on, don't be shy. There we go. There we go, folks. Welcome to Cape Town. I'm not going to shut the engines off because I want to go straight into the replay. What I'm going to do is stick the parking brake on, though. And we will end the replay. Stop. So, look what my landing rate was. 390. Ooh, ouch. Sure it wasn't that bad. We'll have a look. We will have a look, we'll be the judge of this. Was it a really hard landing? I suspect it was, because we did fall out of the sky, so I'm going to go with them on this. Let's have a look. So let's have a look at this one then. Oh yeah, we let the nose drop. Yeah, that was firm. That was firm, definitely. Oops. Oops. So this brings us to the end of this flight. Don't know what all those noises are. I realise you had a choice of flights. Thank you very much for choosing this one. I wish you a pleasant onward browsing journey. And hope to God, that noise is horrendous. It's a replay bug. I'm sorry about that, folks. So if I'm here in Cape Town, I'll leave you with this wing view of our arrival with that iconic backdrop. It's a hard landing, but we averted a disaster, let's put it that way. Oh yeah, that was a real bounce. Oops. Oh well, can't win them all. Perspective, right?
50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
Oof. Yeah, it's not the best. Okay then, until next time. I'm out for now.